The where keyword allows us to filter down the set of results we get back from a query. So in this case, we are taking all of our different cities, and then we are going to filter by this expression right here. So we're going to check the area of each individual row, and we're only going to return it in our final result set if that row's area is greater than 4,000. Besides this greater than sign right here, there are many other comparison operators we can make use of inside of a where statement. So we can check to see if two values are equal to each other, if one value is less than another. We can check to see if two values are not equal to each other. We can even check to see if a value is in between others or contained inside of a list. Let's take a look at how we would check to see if a row's value or some column value is equal to a constant value. So back over here, I'm going to update my where statement, and I'm going to change it to area equal to 8223. Now, unlike many other programming languages where a single equal sign is referred to as assignment operator, we're not doing any assignment here whatsoever. We are doing a comparison. We are saying that we only want to see rows where that row's area is equal to a value of 8,223. So for us, I would expect to only see a result from this query of Tokyo, because that is the only row we have inside of our city's table with an area equal to 8,223. Okay, so let's run this. Now we can see, yep, sure enough, we got Tokyo. We can also check to see if two values are not equal to each other. Let's try updating that same query and try to find all the different rows that don't have an area of 8,223. So I can do either a exclamation equals, that is exclamation equals, you see like so, this font that I'm using inside this editor automatically changes it to that nice looking symbol. If I run that, I see every city that does not have an area of 8,223. And then an equivalent operator that's just written out slightly differently is less than greater than. That also does the same thing. So we can replace that with a less than greater than like so. Run that, and we get the exact same result. Okay, so the thing to keep in mind here is that the comparison that we are doing is executed for every single row inside of our table. Now let's take a look at some of the more advanced checks we can do with between, in, and not in the next video.